Hello everyone, my name is Deeksha Jain and I have secured the 22nd rank in Civil Services Examination 2018. In this video, I will be talking about urbanization. So, what is urbanization? Urbanization is understood both in the demographic and in the sociological sense. Demographically, it is related to the increasing size and density of cities' population. And sociologically, it is about the increasing socio-cultural heterogeneity, and both are mainly the result of migration of rural population to urban areas towards cities. And urbanization in India has been pegged at 31.16% by the 2011 census. So urbanization is a reality. It is an eventual outcome of industrialization of society. Many people move to urban areas in search of good jobs, better educational opportunities, in search of jobs in primary and secondary sectors, in service sector. So many people have left their agricultural occupations and move to urban areas. Now, what we'll be talking about next is the problems associated with urbanization. So first are the structural problems. Indian cities suffer from over-urbanization. In the sense that the population to land ratio and population to resources ratio is very, very high. There is much more population and the resources are very less. So the urban cities are facing many problems because of this. There is a housing problem and prevalence of slums is there. Around 25% of city population is slum dwelling in India. Transport and traffic congestion is another problem. Problem of sanitation and safe drinking water, environmental pollution and health related issues. Increasing diseases, and there are also socio-cultural problems. Here, declining role of social institutions like family, marriage, kinship, neighborhood, etc. Increasing isolation among people, which also has its own psychological effects. Then increasing crimes and immoral activities, increasing drugs, smuggling, etc. Decreasing trust and trust in relationships, breaking down of familial bonds. There is also one more problem which is not in urban areas but because of urbanization, which is the feminization of agriculture. Because a lot of male population has migrated to the cities in order to earn a better living, the women left behind have to take the burden of not only doing domestic responsibilities but also take care of agricultural fields. And the land is not in their name. Many times these women are working as agricultural labor. So it also leads to a certain kinds of deprivation in rural India. So now, there are also certain psychological problems that are associated with urbanization. Fear, psychosis, insecurity, increasing alienation in urban population. So all these problems have been there, and despite urbanization being something, an eventuality which was coming, we have not been able to plan for it properly. So we will now look at certain solution as to how to combat the problems associated with urbanization. Urbanization in itself is not bad. It has taken place in many countries, but there are certain issues that are associated with it and which have to be planned for, and we have to make sure that everybody living in the city is living a decent life. So moving towards the solution, the first one is the promotion of inclusive cities, which means that ensuring affordable urban housing and life to everybody, including the urban poor in the cities. Urban governance needs to be improved. It involves improving transparency and accountability, cutting red tapism, cutting corruption from local government bodies, empowering local government bodies to take important decisions and plan for the future of urbanization. The urban local self-government needs more finances, needs more empowerment, and there need to be also elected leaders who are empowered so that they are responsible to the people of the city. Urban planning is a very important aspect. Many of Indian cities have grown in a very haphazard manner, which has led to problems like flooding during the rainy season. Slums have sprung up everywhere. So there has not been a planned manner in which the cities have expanded. So long-term and effective and sustainable planning needs to be ensured. Effective implementation of smart cities mission is important. Although the smart cities mission, it is not that it is without problems. There needs to be more involvement of local government. Land availability is also an issue. But proper implementation of smart cities mission will ensure that urban life is more smooth, comfortable and less polluting. There is also the Amrit Mission, Atal Mission for rejuvenation and urban transformation, which covers around 500 cities. So that is also another mission that needs to be implemented properly. Basic services to the urban poor need to be provided. We can look at initiatives like Mohalla Clinics in Delhi, which focus on providing free healthcare to everybody, including the urban poor, through local setups within all areas. Need of developing the urban infrastructure is very important. With increasing urban population, infrastructure is coming under immense pressure, and unless it is one, it needs to be renovated at many places. Recently, a footover bridge in Mumbai broke down, leading to the death of many people. And so such structures need to be taken care of well in time so that such disasters don't happen. And at the same time, new infrastructure needs to be robust and in line with the needs of urban areas. Another important scheme in this regard is the Shyama Prasad Mukherjee Urban Mission. What it focuses on in developing urban and rural areas in clusters. If we provide urban facilities, education, opportunities to some extent in rural areas, it can curb the pressure on urban areas. So, urban mission in that aspect is very important. National Urban Livelihood Mission, which endeavors to create self-employment in urban areas. Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana, which also has a component for slum redevelopment. Slum Dwellers' Right to Property Act 2011 to ensure the rights of the slum dwellers. Street Vendors Act, etc. So, all of them need to be implemented properly. There needs to be proper planning. And instead of resisting urbanization, the government has accepted it as an eventuality. So now that we know that it is coming, it is better that we plan for it properly and well in time. And thank you. That will be all in terms of urbanization.
Subscribe to our channel and click on the bell icon to get latest updates on upcoming videos.